it's something that we're still collecting information on. The good news is that we're, you know, the data that we have so far is showing that we're still maintaining really good efficacy rates at that 3-month mark. And as time allows, we're still collecting the data. We'll make sure that we get that information out to everyone. It's something that still is obviously a possibility, but significantly less chance of someone contracting COVID if they are in fact vaccinated. There's also a lot of understanding, not only with the COVID vaccine, but other vaccines, that you get a nice immune response and you come into contact with that infectious agent, so in our case, SARS-CoV-2, and you do contract the actual illness, that it tends to be very, very mild or minimal. So again, even those that do potentially develop the disease after vaccination, much less milder courses. It's important to keep in mind that, you know, warmer months, summer months are coming ahead, and, you know, we are definitely feeling the downward trend in COVID cases in our communities. If you are thinking about traveling, and whether even within state or out of state, it's important to remember that those same mitigation strategies still continue. Now is not the time that we give up. Now is the time that we realize that there is some light at the end of this tunnel. Vaccines, I look at them as an added layer to everything that we're currently doing. It's not a replacement of something. So again, you know, just remember all of those risk mitigation strategies that we've been doing this entire time, with the masking and the social distancing and the personal responsibility. And when it is your chance to get that vaccine, when you are in that phase, to go out and get it as an added measure. Again, a layer on top of what we are doing.